Alright, today we're actually going to do a Let's Play of Terra. It's going to be my very first Let's Play. Now, let's get to making our character, shall we? And yes, we're actually going to be making a ninja. But not just any old ninja, we're going to be the most kawaii ninja out there. Yeah, you heard that right. We're going to fall on girly cutie mode. Little cute security mode. Don't worry, I have just the cosmetics in mind. And I also have them in the wardrobe. So, hooray! I don't know exactly what we're gonna make. Alright, let's go here. This here. Zoom in here. Let's go for the face. We'll do for skin tone. Okay, skin tone's fine. Let's see. For hair color, we're going to make it nice and blonde. Blonde here. That just makes the background. Aww, that's cute. Also, it's reminiscent of my Berserker space, actually. Just didn't know. However, I feel this one will be the best. For adornments, we'll go with this one right here. Or maybe that one? Nah. Let's go with this one. Actually, no, I like that one better. Let's go with this one here. Actually, I'm so tempted to go with that one. Yeah, screw it, we'll go with that one. You're gonna see why we went with that. We're going to see exactly why we're going with that. You're gonna see exactly why we picked that name when we get to the bank. Cutscene's about to pop up, so we're gonna... Oh wait, I'm gonna select it first. Harp, harp. Alright, cutscene's about to happen. So, we're gonna do this cutscene here. Gotta say, really good artists in this community.
The Divine War sundered gods and titans, destroying the world it was. Amid the tragedy, a single drop of hope coalesced to preserve one tiny part. Sheltered from time, a mystical tree grew, giving fresh eyes the power to see the world as the gods once saw it. The world's greatest scholars and magicians came to study the divine tree and protect it. They magically erased the island from mortal records. But not before the forces of evil sent their own champion.
All flat. For the record, gonna say it now. Our guns are, well, they're dicks. Alright, that's that. We are not. We will get our cosmetics. First things first, we gotta do these quests to actually, you know, get rid of the barricade. If we go over there, there's gonna be a barricade there.
For the Federation.
Because the NPC is being a bunch of, well, dunkoffs. Yep, got that. Let's see here. Where's the... I only need to collect one. Herp derp. Herp derp derp. I swear, this is just... Yeah, I've been up all night, confused, just relaxing. Just grinding, doing all kinds of random stuff. Didn't mention I left this game yet. Come on, guys, this is a North American version of TERA. Can you at least speak English, dearies? I gotta say though, with this particular new world, it's kind of a love-hate relationship with me. On one hand, it definitely shows the Argons as the big threat that they are, but on the other hand, good God, this place is dark. I feel like I just spoiled something. Now fuck me. Alright, let's see, are we, got that? Oh yeah, that's right, got the patch. Alright, there we go! It's gonna be real easy. Gentlemen, I introduce to you the bank. At least not yet. It's going to be real smooth bank. Gotta love those banks. Oh, wonderful loading screen. God, that is really pretty. You know that, guys? That is really pretty. I really wish more games were like this.
Looking for me?
Eat your heart out now. Eat your heart out. Yes, I am poking fun at it, but why wouldn't I? I mean, let's be honest, it kind of fails at being a horror game, or at least the newer stuff where it's just jump scare fests. I mean, with the originals, kind of an excuse. Yeah, I should probably start reading that from now on. I'll be sure to do that for y'all. Guys, that mention this game's awesome. You know, before this, before I actually started boot up this Let's Play, made this character and all that jazz, I actually went and, I was actually just chilling, doing some grinds. I like in-game grinds and stuff for Star Power gear, and listening to, Persona 3 Portable, Way of Life or something. It's relaxing. Alright, let's grab these keys. Let the stick. Alright, let's go talk to this guy over here. Yeah, there's a happy little shiny tree. It's gonna be a big old tree. Cool, oh, yeah, new skills. Where's a giant tree or some odd? There's the giant tree. There's the kill. Back is. See how it goes over there. Like that. That's good. Yep, there we go. And he's almost dead. Boom. Oh my. No, I didn't hear a little squish there. Yeah. Welcome to the tutorial level, gentlemen. I wonder why this mud is so sticky on me. Yeah, now that I think of it, they kind of look like cow pies, don't they? I think we might just be picking up cow pies. Wanna know how I look? Wanna know how I know how a cow pie looks? Try living in Kansas. You're gonna know this kind of thing. If you have relatives who happen to know farming and such, yeah, you're gonna know these kinds of things. Anyway, let's see, let's equip that step. There we go. Alright! Now then, since we have Axe of the Bank now, we can actually get our wardrobe cosmetics. I got some stuff just for this. We're gonna look real cute. And also have some rare-ass gear! Or rare costume, rather. Because I know this uniform goes for a shit ton. Alright, almost there. Perfect. Now then, all we need to do is wait for it to load onto our character because it's, because Gabe's being a dip. And there we go. There we go. Now you know why I named it that. Aren't I good at this? I'll be sure and get like a head change and stuff too. Man. Yep. Yep, we have officially, well, I think I could kiss any form of masculine dignity goodbye. Yep. Yep. There goes masculine dignity. But on the bright side, at least we happen to do a shit ton of damage. And look good doing it. You know, kind of think about it. I can think of only, you know... I must have Nui on the brain because, well, I just feel like I might be thinking of Nui right now. With this kind of design here, yep. I think I may have just put Nui Harame in blame. So guys,
what brings you here?
Yep, we have a Kawaii Dairy Dairy Grandpa Killer now in game. It's great, ain't it? Sarcasm.
For me?
this here, follow this, how do I put, let's see, follow this, obviously, this would be very disturbing if I was not an Ellen. I'm going to say that now. If I was not an Ellen, this would be very, very, very creepy. Honestly, it's still kind of creepy. Oh well. As soon as we press this, shit's gonna hit the fan. Commencing shit to fan. I repeat, commencing shit to fan. I'm gonna say it now. My commentary, probably not that entertaining. Or is it? I don't know.
Do you wanna play?
And again, I've been up all night, so what do you expect? Can't expect much. I love how they actually made this way. They will only attack you if you attack them. But you have to attack them. They seem to like me, I think. They seem to like looking at me. I am a looker because these monsters just seem to love the way I look. They really do. Then again, who wouldn't stare at this? Let's be honest, guys. You saw this waltzing around? Would you not stare at it? Anyway, let's show these creep shows here and show them what for.
Looking for me? Yay for new friends!
That's not the time! Now is not the time, and yeah, so Andy, you should probably move a little bit backwards. I move away from the monsters, that would be super fun. And problem solved. You know, I remember back when free-to-play games had shit models. Nowadays, those are on the mobiles!
Do you wanna play?
Actually, even then, the mobile games have more dignity. I remember back when free-to-play games were more like free-to-try and pay to actually do everything else. Nowadays, with games like this beauty here, there's really no excuse for that. Well, hooray, random mumbling. Also, yep, we're looking good from the get-go, fellas. We are looking good from the get-go. You know, I will say, when it comes to fantasy weapons in gaming, I can look at some of them and think maybe some might actually have practical value IRL. And then some of them, like these stars here, like this giant, oversized ninja star, I wouldn't trust that in my life. But at least I look good with it. I really do. Yeah, I think this might actually, yeah, now that I think about it, this is literally like one of the most character cutesy looking Ellens I have ever seen, and yeah, this is a definite contrast compared to my standard Ellens. I mean, most of them I tend to keep like the fancy aesthetic, and during that nice little access video, I actually went and blew a 20 on this game to actually get some of the Federation bills early for that Halo. Yeah, well, that was on 5. And while I was doing that, if you're wondering how I actually bought the coupon thingies, with the Federation bills that I actually needed, I had actually bought Ellen Housemaid uniform boxes, because they are guaranteed to contain them, plus some random cosmetic and stuff like that. That is how I got this dress. And that hat. And not only that, but since this particular animal ear and tail set happens to look like one of the most pampered combinations and stuff, I figured, you know what, we're gonna make the most kawaii looking ninja that will ever be in the game, probably. This is a very, very girly Ellen, and if,
is this worth my time? Something important?
You know, the, and I'm pretty sure a lot of players, if they saw this, they'd think, there's no way a guy's behind this keyboard. There's no way there's a guy behind the screen. Wrong-o. I'm a trap, bitches. I'm a fucking trap. I'm a fucking trap. Ain't I great? Alright, let's beat the shit out of this strange monster that's not loaded in yet. Oh, there he is. That guy's tail looks like an artichoke. Artichokes are pretty good. Especially when you have a nice salt and butter. They're good. They're really, really good. You know, if I knew how to actually record 9 feet from my base cam, you would see one of the most comfortable setups for gaming on. We're talking recliner, mouse, like keyboard on the lap, mouse on the armchair. Yeah. Let's not forget the, there's a little script shot for y'all. Anyway. Let's see here.
This one doesn't have the sight.
Game, I know what you're trying to do. I know you're trying to hint at that, at who's the bad guy, but you kind of failed because you showed too much. Probably should have changed the camera angles a little bit or something, but then we fixed it and done wonders to the narrative, but kind of gave it away just a bit. I still love you, Tara. I really do. So, just imagine how nice these loading screens are. They're really cool.
Something I can help with.
Also, another thing I like about the ninjas is the outfit. I said I'd read this.
You here?
I helped build this village. So many happy memories, torn down, left to burn. But as the children are safe, and as long as Tyrion still stands, everything will be alright. Pampered ninja. I swear, this is gonna be great. Pampered ninja, you survived your encounter with that thing after all. I can't tell you how relieved I am. That was a very brave thing you did. What happened? Who's that man? I couldn't say. When that thing appeared, everyone took cover. You were the only one to stand your ground. If there was a strange man out there, you're the only one who saw him. I do know that the Argonauts all left soon after you fell, and they did even more damage on the way out. They are looking for something, or someone. The children, maybe? Well, where's Daniel? Someone put a bear costume on an Argon. Someone do it. Calm down and safe. Her name is safe. She stayed in the storehouse with her little Jalka. I think that's his name. I cannot pronounce these names for shit. Like you told her to. But some of the other gifted children are unaccounted for. Let's see. I don't know. So, I read that. The Valkyon Federation soldiers from the post on Windmill Hill have arrived to help with the search and rescue. I don't know them. You can trust them. When we first came to this island, the Valkyon Federation provided us with ships, supplies, engineers, and soldiers, just like those men there, to protect us. They've taken good care of it. Taking care of us ever since, so you can rely on the Valkyon Federation, believe me. I suppose. Just that one. You should go talk to them. Have them introduce you to their leader, Doodle. Okay. Ooh, new skill. Right, there we go. Lancers! I wonder if he's new. I mean, he's definitely a new character, but I wonder if he's like an alt or something. You just don't see that many Lancers nowadays, I swear. Brawlers! Everywhere! Can't stand the dang things.
Make it snappy.
Argon's on Stepstone Isle. Just doesn't make sense. Don't make no lick of sense. They hate nature. Pampered Ninja, glad to see you up and around again. We feared the worst when we first found you in the wreckage. This is Captain Dougal from the Valkyon Federation camp up on Windmill Hill. He's arranged to bring us emergency supplies for the cleanup effort, and he's going to lead the assault on the Argon still on the island. You're free to stay and help with the cleanup, but from what I've seen, your talents would be wasted just shifting debris. As you go over Dougal, follow his orders.
Is this worth my time?
Alright, you should go with Dougal, follow his orders, you'll learn a lot. I'll do my best, sir. Whatever happened to being suspicious again?
Something important?
God damn it! Press the... go. That's it. I knew you'd understand. Before you go, you'll want to talk to Anya. She was worried about you, that you wouldn't wake up. She was out looking for the other lost children right now, and I'm sure that she'd love to know you're all right. We're still making our plans for the assault, so you've got a little time when you're ready to join us at the Federation Post up on the hill. Thank you, sir. Well, that was a completely quick change of shift in thingies. Like, it's just like all of a sudden it's like, yeah, I'm not very trusting of them. A few seconds later. Alright then, I'll go help you out. God, it's like my character has rapid cyclic bipolar disorder or some shit.
Have you seen my friends?
Don't cry, Zozo. Everything's gonna be alright. I wouldn't let anything hurt you. Anya, you are talking to cloth and cotton in the shape of a bear. I don't think it understands. Look, Zozo, Damn it!
Is someone there?
Let's see her. Look, Zozo, Pampered Ninja is back! It's got buttons for eyes. It can't see. Are you okay, Pampered Ninja? I was scared when I saw you in the square. You wouldn't wake up. Uncle Jonka says thank you, by the way. He's going to be okay, thanks to you. But no one has seen the other children since that bad man came. You saw his blonde mustache and ass too. No, but he was there. I dreamed about it once. You should probably lay off the sugar. It's bad for you. I also dreamt the other children went into a cave. But I'm afraid to go inside. Something bad will happen. Okay, let's don't go inside then. Then again, though, we know we're going to have to anyway, so we might as well. Let me see. Let me ask if anyone's seen them. Okay. Hey, look, a box. I'm going to try to smack this out of here. Nope.
How can I help?
Okay. Did you say you're looking for the children? There are some survivors in the cave there. Sorry about your village, friend. I haven't been here long, but this place really makes you feel at home. No, it doesn't. No, it does not. If this makes you feel at home, then you must have had a really, really shit home. Because there's Argons everywhere. Anyway, yes, there are definitely survivors in the cave. We passed them on the way down from our camp. Some of them are in bad shape. I don't recall seeing any kids, though. Thanks. Oh, come on, it's a fucking island. Come on. Y'all can't be this incompetent. It's not just an island. It's a tiny fucking thing. Okay, where's it? Over here. Yeah. Here we go.
Hey, where is everybody?
Surprise, Zozo. Everything's gonna be alright. I won't let anything hurt you. Yeah, okay, we read that. I couldn't hear. Did they say they were in the cave? Come on, Pampered Ninja. Let's not. Is it that you're afraid? I'll be okay with you. If you're with me, that's what happens. Alright, Pampered Ninja, stay close to me. Feed up, you little lolly burnet. The dumb lolly blonde dressed up in zero practicality is here to protect your ass first. Let your guard go. Let your bullet magnet go first. Let your bullet magnet go first. It'll save you in the long run. Alright, yes. I was supposed to read the fucking ad. That's here. Yeah. I do not look like I belong here at all. That's here. Sherla, honey, it's okay, baby, don't worry about me. I can't go. Who's up, Sherla? I'm so sure lost her name. She was worried about me, but after she got hurt, and she could hardly breathe. She was way more concerned about me. So I shouldn't have brought her here, but I thought we'd be safe in this cave. Oh, please. Don't let Amy see this. Amy, sweetie, you shouldn't see this. Charlotte's just sleeping, okay? Please, Pampered Ninja, take Amy out of here. I can't bear to see this. And we should probably go. I shouldn't be seeing this either. I'm just a little Pampered Molly Ninja. I shouldn't be seeing this shit.
Is someone there?
I don't think my friends are in the cave, but no shit, Sherlock. Pampered Ninja, do you think they're sleeping too, like Charlotte? We might need to have a talk about that. I don't think they're in the cave, Pampered Ninja. No shit. No shit, Sherlock. And we'll find them, just don't run off. Maybe I'll go, maybe we found them when he came here earlier. Maybe we took them to the soldiers. Hey, look, a panda! And we took the soldiers' camp to the camp with the ninja. I'm sure that's where they are. It's not safe. It's not safe. You stupid brunette. I'm the blonde. I'm supposed to be the stupid one. They are. It's not safe. Yeah, like it's not safe. God, you're brunette. You're supposed to be the smart one. I'm blonde, and I'm going around in battle with the most impractical ninja star in existence. And I happen to be wearing a frilly dress that ain't gonna protect me from shit. And yet I'm the smart one here. There must be some seriously wrong with the head meat. I don't care, I'm going with you. If I don't, something bad will happen. No, you should probably stay back here. If you don't let me go with you, I'll just wait until you're not... fine. But, steakhouse. Okay, let's completely ignore everything that just happened. And by that, I mean Amy's going to completely ignore what he just said and run off. Seriously, why is it that the lolly ninja with that... Why is it that the lolly ninja that is blonde happens to be wearing some of the most impractical outfit, one of the worst things you could possibly wear into battle, and happens to be using a very impractical ninja star? Why is it that I'm the only one talking any amount of sense here? And I'm just curious. I am a failure. Or at least if this particular thing was real. This would be a huge, huge fail, ninja.
Is someone there?
At least I look cute. So many bears. They look wrong. I think they're sick. And it's a pampered ninja. What's wrong with the bears? They're acting strangely. And look, some of them are blue. You think that... Thanks, yeah. Poor Dan, can you introduce your PJ chef friend? Yes. You can run on ahead. Okay, now I'm starting to show my blondness. Ah, the dumb blonde stereotype. It's not to love. What's not to love? Well, no, it's better than a dumb blonde. A dumb blonde lolly. You know? Banya was right. There is something wrong with these bears. They have a log stuck out of their foreheads. It's just like every single bear in this world. Nature's weird like that. Anyway, let's kill them. Put them out of misery. Mercy killing? That's a mercy killing. You have wood stuck out of your head. You have wood coming out of your head, man. This is a mercy killing. Let's kill that there. Save that. Hey, look. It's another Ellen. This one's a little mystic. You've got dragon ears and stuff. Me. Hey, let's grab this here. I'm gonna sell that. The mighty thingy. Yeah, there we go. You know, I remember when I was playtesting a priest, I actually was able to kite and kill every single bear in the area with the debuff skill. It was hilarious. And I remember I was sitting there kiting all of the bears. And somebody was actually sitting there watching me and said, I hope you die from doing that. He was denied that satisfaction because I never did. You know, I'm gonna say it now. Giving a DPS class like this to the Ellen was... It's kind of broken to give it to the Ellen because the Ellen's... One of the reasons I use the Ellen is because they happen to have a... Well, how do I put this? higher animation speed for basically everything they do. Just a teensy bit.
Snack first, then work.
So combine that with a fast-moving class that is focused on DPS, and basically you gave one of the... Like, honestly, giving this to a... Like, giving this class to something like a Mon or a Baraka or something would be the biggest nerf you could possibly give it, because those things are just slow as molasses. Alright, it's working. The bears are steering clear of the camp. These don't look like any anti-sea bear circles. But, what if it's not just the bears? Oh dear, this might be bad. What do you mean? Oh, hi there. You must be Pampered Ninja from the village. I must have been the village queen. This little one has been telling me all about you. She says you're going to join the Valkyon Federation as soon as you leave the island. Is that right? Oh, I'm being rude. I'm handsome. Handsome. I don't know how to pronounce your name. I'm an engineer for the Valkyon Federation. Great to have you aboard. But I wasn't planning. That's great. Yeah, your first order is to help me with the anti-argon devices. I call them anti-argon because if an argon gets close, zap, no more argon. They'll detect even the faintest trace of argon infection. I mean, I think so. I really need someone to test them. Why can't you not zapping anyone? It's close. Okay, well, let me send Anya ahead. Yep, I am officially a dumb blonde.
Is someone there?
It's not much farther to Tyrion, the Sorrow Tree. If we find my friends before I go to sleep. Why do we have to call it the Sorrow Tree? Why can't it be more pretty like Port Alvin? Damn it, I feel like I'm spoiling things. Yeah, it's okay, I'm an Alvin, so fuck it. That's here. It's okay, Paper Ninja. Shortcut, come find me when you're done. Okay, but be careful. I love this idle animation. I love the idle animation. I love the stance of the ninja. Oh my god, I am adorable. Let's not forget the twitching ears. The twitchy ears? What? My ear twitches? I am a cute looking thing. Here we go. You know, I feel like this dress isn't really a dress, but is instead something I would normally wear under the actual outfit. Maybe I could see the stitching here, there, stiff. Although I could be wrong, and it really could just be this strange and cutesy. You know, I wonder why Japan does this. Japan, you're weird, but we love your weirdness. Let me zoom out again. Zoom in, zoom out, zoom in, zoom out. Yeah, cameras. I've gotta love this with the weight. I'm supposed to go up here yet. And they go down here. Yeah. Well, there he is. It's working. First, can't hurry. The anti-organic devices didn't kill you. You were trying to get me killed. That means I can install them all around that big tree. Maybe even the village. First, but sure. Say, that's a good idea. I'll be sure and do that. You should get going. Your little friend is probably waiting for you. Stupid dog. You're making me look smart. You're making me look smart. I'm not supposed to. I'm supposed to be a dumb blonde, damn it. I am concerned for this world. I am very concerned. Grays. Don't grays normally come from UFOs? Illuminati confirmed. This place was made in Area 51. I think. I could be wrong.
What can I tell you?
It's true that we're part of the Federation military, but we're mainly out here to provide security for the researchers. Their work is way too important to the Malkiel Federation. If this tree and these kids can anticipate natural disasters and minimal attacks, it's worth keeping a platoon of troops here. Well, I think that's a little bit of a selfish reason to do it. I'm not liking you much right now. Good to see you again, Pampered Ninja. And yeah, she was here, but she helped to cross the bridge a few minutes ago with Emin and some of the village guardians. They wanted to get a look at Tyrion to see if they had any damage. I don't suspect they'll go far, or go very far. The other end of the bridge is still Argon territory, but it's not safe for civilians yet. I am no civilian. I am the dumb blonde with the frilly dress and just so happens to actually kick ass for some strange reason. And by join them, I mean join the people who are kicking the Argon asses, because the Argons are, well, they're dicks. Berserkers, I play that a lot. It's true that we're part of the we got that already. Before you go, Pampered Ninja, I would love to know for you. Oh, wonderful. I hope I can actually read it. And hopefully I don't smash it with my big hands. You know, I just realized this, but Ellen hands are actually much larger. Like, they're a bit too big. They're big. They're bigger than they should be big. How to put this? They're pretty big. Also,
victory for Balkion.
Alright, let's hear Pepper Ninja. Anya insisted on leaving as soon as she got here. She said that the other children are in danger, and she is the only one who can save them. That's stupid, Burnett. I've gathered all the guardians available and escorting Tyrion. Follow us without delay.
For the Federation.
Oh, sure. Don't wait for my ass. I'm surrounded by morons.
History for Balkion.
Why didn't Emin tell me they were going up to the tree? Yeah, that's a good question. Why didn't they tell you? And why did they leave without me? Idiots. And let's see. We were this close to launching our assault. We could have escorted the girl and rescued the children and finished off the Argoth. Yeah, they were so scary. Did you give them a lobotomy before they came? I'm just wondering. Let me call my troops back to the macro village, Pampered Ninja, and we'll assemble a proper attack force. We'll be ready within the hour. I can't wait that long. Yeah. I got a sugar high, man. Yeah. We can't wait that long. Happen to be made of sugar at all niceness. I'm running on a sugar rush. I am a walking sugar rush. I can't wait. Let's hear it. I understand. Do what you have to do, and may God be with you. And may none of that. Got a fortune path, you know. Let's hear it. I'll stay here long enough to assemble my troops, and we'll follow you as soon as possible. Somehow, I think you can handle yourself until we catch up to you. I can, and I will. Rock band. Let's see here. Where's the... What am I doing? Can I check the question out here? Okay, let me put this up there. Okay, there we go. Cost on her bridge for Anya. Yeah. Yeah, find our brunette. Her brain's missing. Or something. Let's see. Oh my, there goes the frame rate. Things are trying to load in here. Recording at the same time. It's definitely just not possible to run. Nope. Oh boy. There we go. Let's see here. Maybe I should change channel. Try doing that, actually. Maybe that'll help the frame rate a little bit. Let's go to channel 3. Let's change channel, and maybe it might help the frame rate a bit. Maybe. Yeah, helped a little bit, I think. Everywhere at the same time.
Victory for Valkyon! For the Federation!
I know it hurts, soldier, but I'm going to get you out of here and you snap out of it. I need your help. That's a grand sick. You shouldn't be here. It's too dangerous for civilians. It's also too dangerous for children. I think I forgot to mention that I'm an Ellen. I think it's too dangerous for anyone, especially Ellens that are running around like this. did you see a little girl come this way? Yes, did you actually see a little girl come this way besides me? A little girl, there was a little girl with those guardian friends of yours that came through. I told them not to go any further. The temple is overrun. You can see our men getting slaughtered up there. And all seasoned soldiers, and you're just a novice ninja. What makes you think you can make it through? Because I am not that smart. That's why. It's not a matter of that I think I can get through. It's more of I think that It's not a matter of thinking that you'll get through. It's simply a matter of whether it could go horribly wrong. It's more of a lack of thought, actually. That little girl is depending on me. Yeah, she's depending on me not to be a moron.
All for one, one for all.
Ah, three musketeers. God, love those references, I swear. Classic. And I think that's enough for this episode of Let's Play TERA. I will see you all next time.
An honor to meet you.